How far is forever? Does it even matter? How high are the heavens above the earth? What's the significance of a continuum? What does geophysics have to do with your salvation? We're going to look at the mystery of the Ketem, or the mystery in the Book of Mysteries called the East-West Continuum. It was dawn in the Book of Mysteries. The sun is rising, and the disciple and the teacher are watching it rise. And the teacher says, this is the Ketem. It's the word in Hebrew for the east.
And the east is a most critical direction. You see, the Temple of Jerusalem was built according to the Ketem. It had to face the east.
The altar of the sacrifice was at the easternmost end, and the Holy of Holies was at the westernmost end. And everything in between, all the holy things, were in between on an east-west continuum. Everything took place in the temple on this east-west continuum. And most importantly, on the holiest day of the year, Yom Kippur, Day of Atonement, the sins of Israel were removed from the people on this same east-west continuum. The high priest would offer up the sacrifice in the east, and then he would take the blood and sprinkle it on the Ark of the Covenant on the west. He would do everything back and forth on this east-west continuum. And the closing act of this holy day was that he would release the sins of the people onto the scapegoat, and the scapegoat would go from the west to the east. So why? Why did God make it that it had to happen on this east-west continuum, all these things? And it's all about salvation. Why? Well, here's the thing. The earth is a sphere, and so it turns on an axis. It turns east to west on an east-west continuum. Therefore, the earth has a north pole, and the earth has a south pole. It has no east pole, has no west pole. So here's the thing. How far is it from the north to the south? Well, there are two poles, so the distance is limited. It's finite. The north pole is there, and then you have the south pole. All north ends at the south pole, and all south ends at the north pole. That's it. The north-south continuum, it's only a few thousand miles. But God built it on the east-west continuum. That means there's a whole different thing going on, because there's no east pole. There's no west pole. So how far does east go? East goes forever. And west goes forever. So there's no end to it. And back then, nobody knew the earth was a sphere, but God did. All this is a shadow of our atonement in Messiah, our salvation. In Messiah, how far does God remove your sins? He removes your sins for an eternity away. It's infinite. It's eternity. You could never find them again. You could spend eternity seeking, traveling in a direction to find it, and you'll never find it. You can go the other way. You will never find your sins again. That's how far he has removed it from you. And so it is written. Think about it. In the Psalms, it says, how far? As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed your sins from you. That's what it's all about. That there is no end. The love of God for you is as far as the east is from the west. There's no end to it. There's no finiteness about it. You cannot fathom it. You can never exhaust it. You can never know it all, because it is always beyond you. It keeps going and going. There's no pole. There's no pole ending. There's no limit ending how much God loves you. There's nothing, and that's why it took God himself to die for your sins, because God himself is infinite. And therefore, there is no end. Only he could bridge the gap between you and God, which was infinite. And now his love for you has no end. It means it goes on and on and on and on and on. And you can never know the end of it. And so you can spend the rest of your life and the rest of eternity knowing it. Because how much does he love you? As far as the east is from the west. There's a wedding in the Bible that has everything to do with your life.